अनमर ने कैन बी ट्रांसलेटेड इन थ्री डिफरेंट रीडिंग फ्रेम्स डिपेंडिंग ऑन वेयर द डिकोडिंग प्रोसेस बिगिंस। However, only one of the three possible reading frames in an mRNA encodes the required protein. Any sequence of bases that could at least theoretically encode a polypeptide is known as an open reading frame. Often abbreviated to ORF, the reading frame is open in the sense that it does not contain any stop codons that would interrupt its translation into a polypeptide chain. A reading frame that cannot be read into polypeptide because termination codons occurs frequently is said to be blocked. tRNA is the key to decipherning the code words in mRNA. Each type of amino acid has its own type of tRNA which binds it and carries it to the growing end of the polypeptide chain. If the next code word on mRNA calls for it, prokaryotes contain 30 to 40 different tRNAs and eukaryotes have 50 or more tRNAs. Since total standard amino acids are only 22, organisms have different tRNAs that are specific for the same amino acid. Two or more different tRNAs that are specific for same amino acid are termed isoaccepting tRNAs. To describe isoaccepting tRNAs for a particular amino acid, we use specific terminology. For example, two tRNAs specific for glycine would be written as tRNA GIY1 and tRNA GIY2 RNAs. Let's know about rRNA. rRNA associated with a set of proteins to form ribosomes. These complex structures which physically move along an mRNA molecule in 5' to 3' direction catalyze the assembly of amino acids into protein chains. They also bind tRNAs and various accessory molecules necessary for protein synthesis. Ribosomes. Ribosomes are ribonucleoprotein particles that contain rRNA and R proteins. It acts like a small migrating factory. Each ribosome is made up of two subunits, large and small subunits. Each of the ribosome subunits contains rRNA and a number of small proteins. In E. coli, the 30S subunit consists 16S rRNA and 21 R proteins. The 50S subunit contains 23S rRNA, the small 5S RNA and 31 proteins. The systolic ribosomes of new eukaryotes are larger than those of bacteria. The total content of both RNA and protein is greater. The major RNA molecules are longer and there are more proteins. The 60S subunit contains 28S rRNA, that is 4718 nucleotides, and the small 5S rRNA, that is 120 nucleotides, and 5.8S rRNA, that is 160 nucleotides, and approximately 50 proteins. The 40S subunit consists of 18S rRNA, that is 1874 nucleotides, and 33 R proteins. The 70S ribosomes has three tRNA binding sites, P site, A site and E site. P site also called the peptidyl tRNA binding site holds the tRNA molecule that is linked to the growing end of the polypeptide chain. A site, also called the amino acid tRNA binding site, holds the incoming tRNA molecule charged with an amino acid. E site, deacylated tRNA exit via the east side, also called the exit side. Now come to activation of amino acid and attachment to tRNA. The attachment of amino acids to tRNAs is the function of the group of enzymes called amino acid tRNA synthetase. Amino acid tRNA synthetases activate the amino acids by covalently linking them to tRNAs. When a tRNA is charged with the amino acid corresponding to its anticodon, it is called amino acid tRNA. Amino acid tRNA synthetases catalyze this reaction in two steps. Let's know the two steps. In first step, an inactivated amino acid intermediate is formed by reaction between the amino acid and ATP. And in the second step, the amino acid is transferred to the 3' end of the tRNA. The link between formed between the carboxyl group, COOH group of the amino acid, and the OH hydroxyl group attached to either the 2' or 3' carbon on the sugar of the last nucleotide, which is always an A. In amino acylation, the amino acid is linked to the tRNA by a high energy bond and thus is said to be activated. Amino acid plus tRNA plus ATP. In presence of amino acid, tRNA synthetase gives rise to amino acid tRNA plus AMP plus PPI. With a few exceptions, organisms have 20 amino acid tRNA synthetases, one for each amino acid. Attachment of the appropriate amino acid to a tRNA is catalyzed by a specific amino acid tRNA synthetase. Each of the 20 different synthetases recognizes one amino acid and all its compatible or cognate tRNA. Synthetases recognize the anticodon loops and acceptor stems of tRNA molecules. These coupling enzymes link an amino acid to the free 2' to 2' or 3' hydroxyl of the adenosine at the 3' terminus of tRNA molecules by an ATP requiring reaction. The 20 amino acid tRNA synthetases fall into two distinct groups, that is class 1 and class 2. Class 1 enzymes attach the amino acid to the 2' OH group of the terminal nucleotide of the tRNA, whereas class 2 enzymes attach the amino acid to the 3' OH group. When an amino acid has become attached to a tRNA molecule, the tRNA is said to be acylated or charged. The terminal uncharged tRNA refers to a tRNA molecule lacking an amino acid and mischarged tRNA to one acylated with an incorrect amino acid. Now come to protein synthesis. Protein synthesis involves in three steps. First is initiation, second is elongation, and third is termination. Initiation involves binding of small ribosomal subunit to mRNA and then is joined by the 50S subunit. It involves the reactions that precede the formation of the peptide bond between the first two amino acids of the protein. Elongation includes all the reactions from the synthesis of the first peptide bond to addition of the last amino acid. Now come to termination. Termination includes the steps that are needed to release the completed polypeptide chain and the dissociation of the ribosome from mRNA. Now come to initiation. Let's know in details about this three process. Initiation. First is initiation. Initiation of protein synthesis in eubacteria involves association of 30S and 50S subunits. The small and large subunits associate at the ribosome binding site a short nucleotide sequence that precedes the coding region to form an intact राइबोसोम. द राइबोसोम बाइंडिंग साइट इंक्लूड्स द अपस्ट्रीम साइन डालगार्नो सीक्वेंस एंड द इनिशिएशन कोडन. द साइन डालगार्नो सीक्वेंस इज ए शॉर्ट पॉलीप्यूरिन सीक्वेंस दैट इज 5' AGG AGG U 3' सेंटर्ड अबाउट 10 न्यूक्लियोटाइड्स अपस्ट्रीम ऑफ द इनिशिएशन कोडन. द साइन डालगार्नो सीक्वेंस इज कम्प्लीमेंटरी टू ए रीजन एट द 3' एंड ऑफ द 16S RRNA. द वन प्रेजेंट इन द स्मॉल सब यूनिट एंड इट इज थॉट दैट बेस पेयरिंग बिटवीन द टू इज इन्वॉल्व इन द अटैचमेंट ऑफ द स्मॉल सब यूनिट टू द mRNA. इनिशिएशन ऑफ प्रोटीन सिंथेसिस इन यूकैरियोट्स रिजेंबल्स द प्रोसेस इन यू बैक्टीरिया विथ माइनर डिफरेंसेस. यूकैरियोटिक 40S सब यूनिट्स फाइंड देयर राइबोसोम बाइंडिंग साइट्स फॉर इनिशिएटिंग प्रोटीन सिंथेसिस ऑन mRNA इन क्वाइट डिफरेंट वेज. इन यूकैरियोट्स स्मॉल सब यूनिट्स फर्स्ट रिकॉग्नाइज द मेथिलेटेड कैप दैट मार्क्स the 5' end of the mRNA and then scan along the sequence until it locates the initiation codon where they are joined by large subunits. This scanning process in eukaryotic protein synthesis is powered by helicases that hydrolyze ATP. Selection of the initiating AUG is facilitated by specific surrounding nucleotides called the Kozak sequence. 5' ACCAUGG3 3' once the small ribosomal subunit with its bound mate tRNAi is correctly positioned at the start codon, union with the 60S ribosomal subunit completes formation of an 80S ribosome. Eubacterial ribosomes, unlike eukaryotic ribosomes, bind directly to start codons in the interior of an mRNA molecule to initiate protein synthesis. The vast majority of eukaryotic initiation event involves scanning from the 5' cap, but there is an alternative means of initiation in which a 40S subunit associates directly with an internal specialized sequence called an internal ribosomal entry site, IRES. In poliovirus, mRNAs do not have a cap structure, so the 40S ribosomal subunit contacts an IRES provides a clever way for the virus to take over its host cell's translation machinery. On infection, poliovirus produces a protease that cleaves the cellular translation factor EIF4G and thereby renders it unable to bind to ELF4E, the cap binding complex. This shuts down the great majority of host cells translation and effectively diverts the translation machinery to the IRES sequences which are present on viral mRNA. Let's know about initiating amino acids and initiating codon. The synthesis of all proteins starts with the same amino acid methionine. In E. coli and in other eubacteria, the first amino acid in any newly synthesized polypeptide is N-formylmethionine. However, formylation is not necessary because non-formulated methionine can function as an initiator amino acid. Eukaryotes and archaea also use methionine as an initiating amino acid, but it is not formulated methionine. In new bacteria such as E. coli, AUG and GUG and on rare occasions UUG serve as initiation codons. When one of these triplets is present in the initiation position, it is recognized by N-formyl met आर टी आर एन ए एंड एन फॉर्मल मेथियोनिन अपीयर्स आर द फर्स्ट अमीनो एसिड इन द चेन. द मीनिंग ऑफ द ए यू जी एंड जी यू जी कोडन्स डिपेंड्स ऑन देयर कंटेक्स्ट. When the AUG codon is used for initiation, it is read as formyl methionine. When used within the coding region, it represents methionine. Similarly, when GUG codon serves as an initiation codon, it is read as formyl methionine. But when present within the coding region, it codes valine. Initiation in the eukaryotic cytoplasm also always uses AUG as the initiator. Now come to initiation, initiating tRNAs. In both prokaryotes and eukaryotes, the initiator tRNA carries a formylated methionine residue that initiates the protein synthesis. It recognizes the initiating codons AUG or GUG or UUG. Several conserved features of initiator tRNAs distinguish them from elongated tRNAs. These include the absence of base pairing between bases 1 and 72 in the acceptor arm and the presence of three consecutive GC base pairs in the anticodon stem. An unpaired C1 A72 as well as other conserved sequence elements in the acceptor stem are important for the interaction of the initiator tRNA with IF2. The presence of three consecutive GC pairs in the anticodon stem is a conserved feature of initiator tRNAs from eubacteria and archaeobacteria and of eukaryotic cytoplasmic initiator tRNAs. These base pairs are required to allow the initiator tRNA to be inserted directly into the P site. Now come to initiation factors. In addition to mRNA, ribosomes and specific tRNA molecules, initiation requires the participation of several factors termed initiation factors. Eubacteria use three initiation factors numbered IF1, IF2, IF3. IF1 binds over the A site of the small ribosomal subunit and is thought to prevent the initiator tRNA from binding to the A site. IF2 directs the initiator tRNA to its correct position in the initiation complex. It has a ribosome-dependent GTPase activity. The GTP is hydrolyzed when the 50S subunit joins to generate a complete ribosome. IF3 binds to free 30S subunits and prevents premature reassociation of the large and small subunits of the ribosome. Its second function is to control the ability of 30S subunits to bind to mRNA. It also ensures the fidelity of initiation site selection. Select the initiator tRNA for use in initiation. Steps involved in initiation in eubacteria. The first step in initiation is the binding of the mRNA to the 30S subunit. The binding is stimulated by the initiation factor IF3. When not engaged in protein synthesis, the ribosomal subunits exit in the preform. They assemble into complete ribosomes during the initiation process. The initiation codon lies within the partial P site peptidyl site. The initiator tRNA enters into the partial P site. The initiation factor IF2 places the initiator tRNA into the partial P site. When the large subunit joins the complex, the partial tRNA binding sites are converted into the intact P and A sites. Amino acid tRNA complementary to the second codon enters the A site. that is amino acid site. Now the main differences between translation in eubacteria and in eukaryotes occurs during the initiation phase. Eukaryotic cells require more initiation factors than eubacteria. That is 12 factors required for initiation. The factors are named similarly to those in eubacteria. The naming of eukaryotic initiation factors is somewhat confusing. The orthologue of bacterial IF1 is not ELF1 but ELF1A, and the orthologue of IF1F2 is ELF5B, not ELF2. The difference between the initiating and elongating metRNA is maintained in eukaryotes, but its structural basis is different from that in eubacteria. The initiator tRNA is called tRNA met. In the process of initiation factors ELF2 and ELF3 bind to the 40S ribosomal subunit. The ELF3 maintains the free 40S subunit. ELF2 is the trimeric GTP binding protein. The GTP bound active form, it binds to tRNA met. This is called the ternary complex. Binding of ELF3 and ternary complex with 40S ribosomal subunit gives 43S initiation complex. This complex formation is independent of the presence of mRNA. Initiation factor ELF4F binds to the mRNA. ELF4F is a heterotrimer consisting of ELF4G, ELF4E and ELF4A. ELF4G acts as a scaffold protein which links other components of the initiation complex. ELF4E, that is cap binding protein, binds the 5' cap. ELF4A acts as a helicase that unwinds any secondary structure at the 5' end. Subsequently, factors ELF4B join the ELF4F mRNA complex. ELF4B stimulates the RNA helicase activity of ELF4A. The ELF4F mRNA ELF4B complex joins the 43S pre-initiation complex through protein-protein interaction. The 3' poly tail of mRNA also participated in the formation of an initiation complex at the 5' end. The poly A binding protein associated with the 3' poly tail interacts with ELF4G. This implies that the mRNA will have a circular organization during protein synthesis. The 43S pre-initiation complex then translocates along the mRNA on an ATP-dependent process called scanning until it encounters the AUG initiation codon. It is assisted by the factor ELF1 and ELF1A. The small subunit stops when it reaches the initiation site and forms a 48S complex. ELF5 and ELF5A, a GTPase activating protein, joins the growing assembly. It induces GTP hydrolysis by ELF2. Hydrolysis causes the release of factors ELF2 and ELF3. Finally, the factor ELF5B enables the 60S subunit to join the complex. Before ELF2 can participate in another round of initiation, its bound GDP must be replaced with a GTP. दिस प्रोसेस इज कैटलाइज्ड बाय ELF2B ए गुआनाइन न्यूक्लियोटाइड एक्सचेंज फैक्टर GEF. वेलकम टू इलोंगेशन. इलोंगेशन इज ए साइक्लिक प्रोसेस ऑन द राइबोसोम ऑन हुईच इन हुईच वन अमीनो एसिड एट ए टाइम इज एडेड टू द नेसेंट पेप्टाइड चेन. द पेप्टाइड सिक्वेंस इज डिटरमाइंड बाय द ऑर्डर ऑफ द कोडन्स इन द mRNA. इलोंगेशन रेट इन ई कोलाई इज रफली 15 अमीनो एसिड्स पर सेकेंड. राइबोसोम्स इलोंगेट पॉलीपेप्टाइड चेन्स इन थ्री स्टेजेस, दैट इज डिकोडिंग, ट्रांसपेप्टिडेशन एंड ट्रांसलोकेशन. लेट्स नो अबाउट डिकोडिंग. डिकोडिंग इन दिस केस द राइबोसोम सिलेक्ट्स एंड बाइंड्स एन अमीनो एसिड्स जे tRNA हुज एंटीकोडन इज कम्प्लीमेंटरी टू द mRNA codon in the A site. Now come to transpeptidation. During transpeptidation, the peptidyl group on the P site of tRNA is transferred to the amino acid group in the A site through the formation of peptide bond. Now come to translocation. In translocation, A site and P site tRNAs are respectively transferred to the P site and E site accompanied by their bound mRNA, that is the mRNA together with its base paired tRNAs is ratcheted through the ribosome by one codon. The process of elongation in eubacteria is aided by three protein factors called elongation factor. First is EFTU or EF1A. Directs the next tRNA to its correct position in the ribosome. EFTS, that is EF1B, regenerates EFTU after the hydrolysis of attached GTP molecule. Now come to EFG. EF2 mediates translocation. The process of polypeptide chain elongation on a ribosome. Let's know about it. Elongation factor EFTU mediates the entry of the amino acid tRNAs into the A site. To do so, EFTU first binds to GTP. The activated EFTU-GTP complex binds to the tRNA. Next, hydrolysis of the GTP of the complex to GDP helps drive the binding of the amino acid tRNA to the A site, at which point the EFTU is released, leaving the new tRNAs in the A site. Elongation factor EFTS mediates the release of EFTU-GTP from the ribosome and the regeneration of EFTU-GTP. Kiromycin is an antibiotic that inhibits the function of EFTU and thus protein synthesis. The carboxyl end of the polypeptide chain is uncoupled from the tRNA molecule in the P site and joined by a peptide bond to the amino acid linked to the tRNA molecule in the A site. This reaction of protein synthesis is catalyzed by a peptidyl transferase enzyme. The amino group of the amino acid tRNA attacks the carbonyl group of the ester linkage of the peptidyl tRNA to form a tetrahedral intermediate. This intermediate collapses to form the peptide bond and releases the deacylated tRNA. Peptidyl transferase is an integral part of the large subunit of ribosomes. Peptide bond formation involves an acyl group O to N migration and converts an ester to an amide. In bacteria, peptidyl transferase activity can be detected in the 50S ribosomal subunit and several ribosomal proteins and are thought to play a role in the activity. The primary activity of peptidyl transfer, however, is a ribozyme activity encoded in the 23S rRNA. The new peptidyl tRNA in the A site is translocated to the P site as the ribosome moves exactly 3 nucleotides along the mRNA molecule going in the 5 prime to 3 prime direction. This step is mediated by the elongation factor EFG and is driven by splitting a GTP to GDP. This action releases the uncharged tRNA from the P site and transfers the newly formed peptidyl tRNA from the A site to the P site. The uncharged tRNA in the P site moves to a third position, the E or exit site of the ribosome. In contrast to the initiation stage of the translation, the machinery used during the course of translation elongation has been highly conserved across prokaryotes and eukaryotes. Because of this conservation, it is assumed that the mechanisms underlying elongation are the same eukaryotes as they are in prokaryotes. Now come to termination. Let's know about termination. Protein synthesis ends when one of the three termination codons, that is UAG, UAA and UGA, is reached. UAG triplet is called the AMBER codon. UAA is the OCHRI codon and UGA is sometimes called OPAL codon. The A site is now entered not by a tRNA but by a protein release factor. Eubacteria have three types of release factors. Release factors RF1 and RF2 recognize the stop codons. RF1 recognizes the terminal codons 5 prime UAA3 and U5 prime UAG3. The RF2 recognizes 5 prime UAA3 and 5 prime UGA3. RF1 and RF2, after recognizing the termination codons, activate the ribosome to hydrolyze the bond between tRNA and polypeptide. RF1 and RF2 recognize the stop codon and stimulate polypeptide release through a GGQ glyglyggin motif, which acts as a peptide anticodon. Release factor RF3 stimulates release of RF1 and RF2 from the ribosome after termination in a reaction requiring energy from the hydrolysis of GTR. Release factor. Let's know about release factor. RF1 recognizes the termination codon 5 prime UAA3 prime and 5 prime UAG3 prime. RF2 recognizes 5 prime UAA3 and 5 prime UGA3. RF3 stimulates dissociation of RF1 and RF2 from the ribosome after termination. Eukaryotes have only two release factors, ERF1, which recognizes all three termination codons, and ERF3. The role of ERF3 is not clear. The release factors terminate translation, but they do not appear to be responsible for the dissociation of the ribosomal subunits. This is the function of an additional protein called ribosome recycling factor, RRF. This acts together with EFG in a reaction that uses hydrolysis of GTP. RRF probably enters the P or A site and unlocks the ribosome. Dissociation requires energy, which is released from GTP by EFG, one of the elongation factor, and also requires the initiation factor IF3 to prevent the subunits from attached together again. Among prokaryotes, translation in the archaea more closely resembles the eukaryotes rather than in eubacteria. The archaeal ribosome is similar to the eubacteria ribosome That is 70S. However, the other features like nature of mRNA and process of in translation initiation are similar to eukaryotes. Rates and energetics of translation at 30 degree centigrade, an E. coli ribosome can synthesize a 30 residue polypeptide chain in about 20 seconds. The energy cost for this process is high. 2 ATPs is required to charge the tRNAs. Because the ATP is cleaved to AMP and PPI, and PPI is subsequently hydrolyzed. 1 GTP is needed for initiation. Total N1 GTP is GTPs are required to form the N1 peptide bonds in the EFTU GTP hydrolysis step. Similarly, N1 GTPs are necessary for the N1 translocation steps. Finally, 1 GTP is required in termination. So for the synthesis of polypeptide of 100 amino acid residues is 40 ATPs and GTPs are required. Thank you. Let's know about eukaryotic translation. First is initiation. Cap dependent initiation. A special tag bound to the 5 prime end of an mRNA molecule, the 5 prime cap, as well as with the 5 prime UTR. The protein factors bind the small ribosomal 40S subunit, and these initiation factors hold the mRNA in place. The eukaryotic initiation factor T is associated with the small ribosomal subunit and plays a role in keeping the large ribosomal subunit from prematurely binding. ELF3 also interacts with the ELF4F complex, which consists of three other initiation factors, ELF4A, ELF4E and ELF4G. The ELF4G is a scaffolding protein that directly associates with both ELF3 and the other two components. ELF4E is a cap binding protein. It is the rate limiting step of cap dependent initiation and is often cleaved from the complex by some viral proteases to limit the cell's ability to translate its own transcripts. This is a method of hijacking the host machinery in favor of the viral messages. ELF4A is an ATP-dependent RNA helicase which aids the ribosome in resolving certain secondary structures formed by the mRNA transcript. This is another protein associated with the ELF4F complex called the poly-A binding protein, which binds the poly-A tail of most eukaryotic mRNA molecules. This pre-initiation complex, accompanied by the protein factors, move along the mRNA chain toward its 3 prime end, scanning for the start codon on the mRNA, which indicates where the mRNA begins coding for the protein. In eukaryotes and archaea, the amino acid encoded by the start codon is methionine. The met-charged initiator tRNA is brought to the P site of the small ribosomal subunit by eukaryotic initiation factor 2. It hydrolyzes GTP and signals for the dissociation of several factors from the small ribosomal subunit, which results in the association of the large subunit. The complex ribosome ATS then commences translation elongation, during which the sequence between the start and stop codons is translated from mRNA into an amino acid sequence. Thus, a protein is synthesized. Regulation of protein synthesis depends on phosphorylation of initiation factor ELF2, which is a part of the MET tRNAi complex. When large numbers of ELF2 are phosphorylated, protein synthesis is inhibited. This would occur if there is amino acid starvation or there has been a virus infection. Yet naturally, a small percentage is of this initiation factor is phosphorylated. Another regulator is 4EBP, विच बाइंड्स टू द इनिशिएशन फैक्टर ELF4E फाउंड ऑन द 5' कैप ऑन द mRNA स्टॉपिंग प्रोटीन सिंथेसिस टू अपोज द इफेक्ट्स ऑफ द 4EBP ग्रोथ फैक्टर्स फॉस्फोरिलेट 4EBP reducing its affinity for ELF4E and permitting protein synthesis. In eukaryotes, the sequences near the AUG appear to be less important. Usually, the first AUG in the mRNA is used to initiate translation. After the translocation of the mRNA, the 60S subunit binds the and allows translation to occur. Now come to cap independent initiation. The cap independent mode of translation initiation in eukaryotes is the internal ribosome entry site approach. In cap independent translation does not require the ribosome to start scanning from the 5' end of the mRNA cap until the start codon. The ribosome can be trafficked to the start site by ITAFs, that is IRES, transacting factors, bypassing the need to scan from the 5' UTR. In translation of specific mRNAs, despite cellular stress or the inability to translate most mRNAs, examples include factors responding to apoptosis, stress-induced responses. Now come to elongation. Elongation is a spiral process. The growing peptide chain is bound to a tRNA in the P site of the ribosome. The appropriate amino acid tRNA determined by the codon binds the A site acceptor site of the ribosome, that is, this binding requires GTP hydrolysis. The peptidyl transferase activity of the ribosome then forms a peptide bond. That means the energy required is contained in the amino acid tRNA, which required 2 ATP equivalents for synthesis. The peptidyl transferase activity is thought to be mediated by the rRNA, the mRNA or tRNA. Peptide is translocated in a GTP-dependent process, moving the P site and exposing an empty A site. The old tRNA dissociates and the ready for the next tRNA. Elongation requires 4 ATP equivalents for each amino acid. This energy is required both to form the peptide bonds and to ensure that the formation from the mRNA is accurately translated into protein sequence. Translation can also be affected by ribosomal pausing, which can trigger endonucleolytic attack of the mRNA, a process termed mRNA no-go decay. Ribosomal pausing also aids co-translational folding of the nascent polypeptide on the ribosome and delays protein translation while it is encoding mRNA. This can trigger ribosomal frame shifting. Now come to termination. Stop codons usually do not have tRNA. Instead, a releasing factor binds to the ribosome and expands 1 GTP in hydrolyzing the peptide tRNA bond. Termination of elongation depends on the eukaryotic release factors. The process is similar to that of prokaryotic termination. So, proofreading. Let's know about proofreading. The fidelity of the protein synthesis depends on the accuracy of the two mechanisms, the linking of each amino acid टू इट्स कॉरेस्पॉन्डिंग टी आर एन ए मॉलिक्यूल्स एंड बेस पेयरिंग ऑफ द कोडन्स इन एम आर एन ए टू द एंटीकोडन इन द टी आर एन ए. थैंक यू.